I'm attorney Pat Dunn. Auto accidents are a part of life. I hope you never need an attorney, but if you do, the team at the Mack Law Firm is here to help. Don't be intimidated by large insurance companies who just want to make your problem go away. We are here to represent your rights and interests. Contact me today at tangilawteam.com and let's get to work.
I'd like to call public hearing to order for November 28th, 2022. The first item on public hearing is TP Ordinance 2278, an ordinance to enact Chapter 44, Railroad Crossing Maintenance. The next item is TP Ordinance 2279, an ordinance placing a 15-mile-an-hour speed limit sign on Fayette Lane, Blakely Place, and Atmore Place of Silver Hill Subdivision, Phase 1 in District 2. The next item is TP Ordinance 2281, an ordinance to grant a variance to Section 36.112, Special Classification Property Development Standards, A, mobile/manufactured home placement standards for placement on a single lot for Charlotte Matthews, assessment number 201307 in District 1. The next item is TP Ordinance 2283, an ordinance amending and enacting Chapter 8, Amusements, Special Events. The next item is TP Ordinance 2284, an ordinance to declare surplus of a 2012 Ford Expedition, asset number 23544, a 2012 Chevrolet Silverado, asset 21550, and authorize the donation of said surplus assets to the town of Kentwood. The last item is TP Ordinance 2285, an ordinance to declare surplus of a 2017 Dodge 1500, asset 24180, a 2015 Dodge 1500, asset 21301, a 2015 Dodge 1500, asset 21525, and authorize the donation of said surplus assets to the Town of Amite City Police Department. If no one wants to speak on any of those items, we'll close public hearing and go into our regular business meeting. Please mute or turn off your cell phones. We'll have our invocation by Mr. Kevin Greer, followed by the Pledge of Allegiance led by Eli LeBlanc. Please stand.
Let's bow our heads. Father, we thank you for this day and all your many blessings. We just thank you for all that you do for us. We ask you to be with us tonight as we conduct business, and that we do it in a manner that's pleasing to you. Father, we just thank you for those who protect our citizens and protect us. Just guide them and direct them as they do that service. We ask you all these things in your precious name, in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
All right, thank y'all. Mr. Z, would you call roll, please?
Mr. Forrest.
Here.
Mr. Engraffia.
Here.
Mr. Joseph.
Present.
Mr. Bruno.
Yes.
Mr. Richtel.
Here.
Mr. Mayhew.
Here.
Mr. Wells.
Here.
Mr. Vial.
Here.
Ms. Hyde.
Here.
Ms. Coates.
Here.
All right. Hopefully everyone's had a chance to read over their minutes from the November 14th meeting. If there are no corrections or questions, I'll entertain a motion.
So moved.
I'll second.
Motion by Mr. Joseph, second by Mr. Wells. Roll call, please.
Mr. Engraffia?
Yes.
Mr. Joseph?
Yes.
Mr. Bruno?
Yes.
Mr. Richtel?
Yes.
Mr. Mayhew?
Yes.
Mr. Wells?
Yes.
Mr. Vial?
Yes.
Ms. Hyde?
Yes.
Ms. Coates?
Yes.
Mr. Forrest?
Yes.
All right. Would anyone like to address an agenda item that was not heard on public hearing? Okay. If not, Mr. President Miller will come and give us his report.
Good evening, everyone. I hope everybody had a great Thanksgiving. And we will start with first item is the financial report. You should have it on your space there and emailed to you. And as always, if you have any questions or comments that you need more specifics about, please call and we'll get that for you. First item with any action is approval of bid for landfill alternative daily cover. LSC Environmental Products was the low bidder, the only bidder, $367.24 per 1,000 gallons. This is the cover that we use every day to, we have to cover the garbage every day. And it's, when we can, we use this. And it's pretty much every day. The only time we can't use if it's raining real hard, we have to use dirt. But this is less expensive and more efficient to take care of the garbage daily.
So moved.
Second.
Have a motion by Mr. Beal, second by Mr. Forrest. Roll call, please.
Mr. Joseph.
Yes.
Mr. Bruno.
Yes.
Mr. Richtel.
Yes.
Mr. Mayes.
Yes.
Mr. Wells.
Yes.
Mr. Beal.
Yes.
Ms. Hyde.
Yes.
Ms. Coates.
Yes.
Mr. Forrest.
Yes.
Mr. Engrafia.
Yes.
Thank you very much. The next item is approval of the 2023 Section 8 housing payment standards. We do this every year. The actual payments are in your packet review, and we just need to be able to do that so that the payments can be adjusted properly.
So moved.
Second.
I have a motion by Mr. Joseph, second by Mr. Mayhew. Roll call, please.
Mr. Bruno. Yeah. Mr. Richtel.
Yes.
Mr. Mayhew.
Yes.
Mr. Wells.
Yes.
Mr. Beal.
Yes.
Ms. Hyde.
Yes.
Ms. Coates.
Yes.
Mr. Forrest.
Yes.
Mr. Engrafia.
Yes.
Mr. Joseph.
Yes.
Thank you. Actually, we have we've discussed with y'all through a miscommunications and a little misunderstanding. We didn't have it on the agenda, but we need to add, if it's okay with you, some blighted properties that we need to get cleaned up. There were five, but I will say that one of them was taken care of by the property owner, so there's only four we have to deal with tonight. There's a list, a packet you all have that has them in here. The one at Galatas Street, 26236, was taken care of by the owner. So I think, Mr. John, that's in your district, is that right?
Yeah.
So that was taken care of. There's pictures of the before and after for that one. But the other four, do we need to do them individually? Do we need to do them as a group?
I think
to add them to the agenda, and then we have to take action.
Yeah, one motion to add all four would be okay. Good, and then we'll take each one individually. All right.
Second.
I have a motion by Mr. Richtel, second by Ms. Coates, to add these items to the agenda. Roll call, please.
Mr. Richtel.
Yes.
Mr. Mayhew.
Yes.
Mr. Wells.
Yes.
Mr. Beal.
Yes.
Ms. Hyde.
Yes.
Ms. Coates.
Yes.
Mr. Forrest.
Yes.
Mr. Engrafia.
Yes.
Mr. Joseph.
Yes.
Mr. Bruno.
Yes.
Thank you. So we have four properties that we are asking for your resolution so we can go forward with the cleanup. I do believe there's one or two that might have comments from the property owner. Do we do them one at a time?
I would read the address and then we'll let them come up.
So we'll start with 42147 Range Road. It's in your packet. I'm not sure if anybody says, is there anyone here for that? There's not, so.
Okay, all right. So we'll go ahead and adopt that resolution. Adoption of TP Resolution R2237, a resolution of the Tangipahoa Parish Council / President Government to approve the condemnation of structures located at 42147 Range Road, Ponchatoula, Louisiana 70454, assessment number 1714406 in District 8.
Yes, my district. Also move.
Second.
I have a motion by Mr. VL, second by Mayhew. Roll call, please.
Mr. Mayhew.
Yes.
Mr. Wells.
Yes.
Mr. Beal.
Yes.
Ms. Hyde.
Yes.
Ms. Coates.
Yes.
Mr. Forrest.
Yes.
Mr. Engrafia.
Yes.
Mr. Joseph.
Yes.
Mr. Bruno.
Yes.
Mr. Richtel.
Yes.
Thank you very much. The next one is 14618 West David Drive, and that is assessment number 905305. And I think we do have someone here for this, is that correct?
I have two people. Ms. Marilyn Morrell.
Yes.
You can come to the mic. You can come to the podium. Please state your name and your address.
Hi, my name is Marilyn Morrell. I live at 17642 Villa Lake Avenue in Greenwood Springs, Louisiana. I sold the house in 1989. I have not have any affiliation with it since then. It's been 40 years ago, and it's the first I've heard about the house.
Thank you. And I believe we have the current owner. There must have been something happened where it didn't get filed properly. Whenever our abstract was done, it tracked it back to her, and it shouldn't have. Right. But I think the current owner may be here. I'm not sure if you have anything to say or if you're going to go along with taking care of the property.
I have a Dewey Dobson.
Thank you very much. Yes, ma'am.
Thank you, Ms. Morrell. State your name and address, please.
My name is Dewey Dobson. My address is 1408 Martins Drive, Hammond, Louisiana, 70401. The property was bought by my parents. Subsequently, my father had a nervous breakdown and was incapacitated. My mother passed away several years later. My wife and I finished paying off the property the last 8 or 9 payments. We tried to get the property. It was processed through Bobby Drude, the loan was, and we never could get any paperwork from Bobby Drude saying it was paid off. So I was kind of left in limbo on what to do and how to go about it. And I have no experience in any of this, so I really didn't know what to do. I've been paying the taxes every year since my father passed away. He survived my mother, but like I said, he didn't live long enough to pay it off, and neither one of them had a will. So we were kind of in the jam with the whole thing. I was hoping I could get it in my name through squatter's rights, but they told me that wouldn't work. I don't know why, but we really didn't have any problems with the house until 2016 when we got the floods. We got 2 inches of water in the house in March, or I believe it was March. And then in August, we got 6 inches of water in the house. And after that, we moved out and we were just going to let it go. I was hoping to keep the house till I retired and then be able to go in and just gut it and fix everything up. Then I got the letter stating that it had to be razed or demolished. So that's pretty much where we're at right now.
Mr. Buddy, you have anything? This is your district.
Well, is Jeff here?
Jeffrey, yes.
Yeah, he's behind Robbie.
Well, Jeff, I didn't know where we stood with the property. You give them a time frame on what to do and when to do it. Can they get an extension or something that would assist them, or is there any other assistance that the parish could give them?
Ultimately, that would be up to you. So the property, as he indicated, has been in this shape since 2016.
Correct.
Well, not this bad. A lot of this happened through Ida.
But ultimately, you could, as a council, could potentially give a time frame in which you would like for him to return and show some sort of progress relative to what he corrects on the residence.
Okay.
I have been in communication at least through a third party. I believe the original owner's brother, and you communicate, and he said he had spoken to you.
Yes.
Needless to say, I wouldn't be opposed to this property owner getting a little bit more time, right, since he's here. But I mean, it has been in disrepair since 2016. And it's progressively getting worse. If you can see some of the photos that have been submitted, it's in my opinion a danger to the nearby residents of the neighborhood. It looks as though anyone can access it. So that's my.
Now, Jeff, if Dewey doesn't do anything, we have a procedure where we do it and put it on his tax roll. Is that correct? Or
yeah,
not.
That's what we're here for right now.
Okay.
So basically, if you vote to condemn said property, then the parish would begin the process of looking at a contractor to clean the property, make it safe, and then they would lien the property for the cost in which you would take to do that.
Dewey, if we give you an extension, do you think you can accomplish this where we didn't go through the, have to go through the other procedure?
My main problem is getting in my name. I don't want to spend a bunch of money and then it's still, you know, in the heirs, because most of them, I don't even know where they are. But like I said, I've been paying the taxes on it for 20 plus years. And I mean, I really have no love for the property, I'll be honest with you. So, I mean, if you got to tear it down, tear it down.
Sir, but, if you've been paying taxes that long,
if you've been paying the taxes for that long and it's not been contested, you can take that to a tax sale. It would be a sheriff's sale, and they would sell the property, and you would be able to get title to that property. Because if the other ones have not pitched in, I think now they changed the law. It's 5 years you got to pay the taxes. So if you've paid it that long, you probably have a case to have the land without going through all of that stuff.
You see, that's what I was trying to do. I talked to Junior Matthau, and he told me that they didn't do the squatter's rights things.
Well, no, it wouldn't be squatter's rights. Yeah. This would be strictly because you paid the taxes as the only heir that paid the taxes. As long as you have receipts for that,
yeah,
then you can have a lawyer petition and have that thing brought to sheriff's sale, and you can get you know the title to that piece of property.
Yeah.
So you're going to have to acquire a lawyer to do that for you. But if you want to keep the property, that's going to probably be the only way you can do it.
Yes, sir.
I think the situation he's in right now, Carlo, is I've seen the property. The cost of there is no value to the house. He's going to have a lot. It's probably going to cost him more to clean that property up than what the lot's worth.
Right.
So that's the situation you're in right now.
Yeah.
Well, he might be better to let us clean it.
That's what I'm saying.
You know.
That's fine.
I mean, it looks pretty rough when you look at the pictures. I mean, I haven't gone to the site, but it's, I know Mr. Ridgel has. It's pretty rough. I don't know if it's, I don't think it's salvageable just looking at the pictures.
What you want to do,
Brad? I'm not an expert.
Go ahead with the
make your motion.
I submit.
I'll second his motion.
Well, I need to read the resolution first.
I'm sorry.
Adoption of TP Resolution R-2235, a resolution of the Tangipahoa Parish Council President Government to approve the condemnation of structures located at 14618 West David Drive, Hammond, Louisiana, 70401, assessment number 903305 in District 5. I have a motion by Mr. Ridgedale, second by Mr. Bruno. Roll call, please.
Mr. Wells?
Yes.
Mr. Vial?
Yes.
Ms. Hyde?
Yes.
Ms. Coates?
Yes.
Mr. Forrest?
Yes.
Mr. Ingrapia?
Yes.
Mr. Joseph?
Yes.
Mr. Bruno?
Yes.
Mr. Ridgedale?
Yes.
Mr. Mayhew?
Yes.
No, he's retired.
You're welcome.
We start at the bottom moving forward, right?
Yeah.
So we're at 14053 Wadesboro. You want to read that resolution?
Is there anyone to speak on that one? I don't think so. Okay, adoption of TP Resolution Number R-2234, a resolution of the Tangipahoa Parish Council President Government to approve the condemnation of structures located at 14053 Wadesboro Road, Ponchatoula, Louisiana, 70454, assessment number 2035901 in District 10.
I so move.
Second here.
Okay, I have a motion by Ms. Coates, second by Mr. Vial. Roll call, please.
Mr. Vial?
Yes.
Ms. Hyde?
Yes.
Ms. Coates?
Yes.
Mr. Forrest?
Yes.
Mr. Ingrapia?
Yes.
Mr. Joseph?
Yes.
Mr. Bruno?
Yes.
Mr. Ridgedale?
Yes.
Mr. Mayhew?
Yes.
Mr. Wells?
Yes.
Thank you. And then the last one we're working on today would be 13209 Wadesboro Road in Ponchatoula, assessment 480-7200.
Adoption of TP Resolution R2233, a resolution of the Tangipahoa Parish Council slash President Government to approve the condemnation of structures located at 13209 Wadesboro Road, Punchatoula, Louisiana, 70454, assessment number 480-7200 in District 10.
Yeah, this one's pretty bad. Ida almost put half the house in the middle of the road, so it really needs to be taken care of. So I'll also move on this one.
Second.
I have a motion by Ms. Coates, second by Mr. VL. Roll call, please.
Ms. Hyde?
Yes.
Ms. Coates?
Yes.
Mr. Forrest?
Yes.
Mr. Ingraffia?
Yes.
Mr. Joseph?
Yes.
Mr. Bruno?
Yes.
Mr. Richtel?
Yes.
Mr. Mayhew?
Yes.
Mr. Wells?
Yes.
Mr. VL?
Yes.
Thank you very much. Just for to note, on this process that we've begun, this department and the work that we've done, there's been six properties. Jeffrey, I'm correct.
Yes, sir.
In addition to these, there's been six properties that are completely cleaned up without having to go through this process, just by notifying the ownership and taking care of. So it's working. The idea that we're moving on it, we're doing it whenever we have to, is getting our citizens and the property owners who are responsible to take care of it. So it's very successful. Thank you for funding and helping us do this and the support for these resolutions as we move forward. Thank you very much. Anybody have any questions for me regarding anything else?
No, I just want to say thanks for the work y'all are doing here, administration, and I know Jeffrey's worked hard at this, but it's really taken hold. As you said, there are six properties out there that said, hey,
we didn't have to go through this.
We don't
process.
Have to go through this. These people are serious. We're cleaning this up, and right. That's what we want.
Thank you all very much.
Thank you.
Regular business. The first item we have is adoption of TP Ordinance 2278, an ordinance to enact Chapter 44, Railroad Crossing Maintenance.
So moved.
Second.
I have a motion by Mr. Mayhew, second by Mr. VL. Roll call, please.
Ms. Coates?
Yes.
Mr. Forrest?
Yes.
Mr. Ingraffia?
Yes.
Mr. Joseph?
Yes.
Mr. Bruno?
Yes.
Mr. Richtel?
Yes.
Mr. Mayhew?
Yes.
Mr. Wells?
Yes.
Mr. VL?
Yes.
Ms. Hyde?
Yes. Adoption of TP Ordinance 2279, an ordinance placing 15-mile-an-hour speed limit signs on Fayette Lane, Blakely Place, and Atmore Place of Silver Hill Subdivision Phase 1 in District 2.
So moved.
Second.
I have a motion by Mr. Ingraffia, second by Mr. Joseph. Roll call, please.
Mr. Forrest?
Yes.
Mr. Ingraffia?
Yes.
Mr. Joseph?
Yes.
Mr. Bruno?
Yes.
Mr. Richtel?
Yes.
Mr. Mayhew?
Yes.
Mr. Wells?
Yes.
Mr. VL?
Yes.
Ms. Hyde?
Yes.
Ms. Coates?
Yes.
Adoption of TP Ordinance 2281, an ordinance to grant a variance to Section 36.112, Special Classification Property Development Standards, A, Mobile / Manufactured Home Placement Standards for placement on a single lot for Charlotte Matthews, Assessment 201307 in District 1.
I'd like to make that motion, please.
Second.
A motion by Mr. Forrest, second by Mr. Ingraffia. Roll call, please.
Mr. Ingraffia?
Yes.
Mr. Joseph?
Yes.
Mr. Bruno?
Yeah.
Mr. Richtel?
Yeah.
Mr. Mayhew?
Yes.
Mr. Wells?
Yes.
Mr. VL?
Yes.
Ms. Hyde?
Yes.
Ms. Coates?
Yes.
Mr. Forrest?
Yes.
Adoption of TP Ordinance 2283, an ordinance amending and enacting Chapter 8, Amusements, Special Events.
So moved.
Second here.
Motion by Mr. Ingraffia, second by Mr. VL. Roll call, please.
Mr. Joseph?
Yes.
Mr. Bruno?
Yes.
Mr. Richtel?
Yes.
Mr. Mayhew?
Yes.
Mr. Wells?
Yes.
Mr. VL?
Yes.
Ms. Hyde?
Yes.
Ms. Coates?
Yes.
Mr. Forrest?
Yes.
Mr. Ingraffia?
Yes.
Adoption of TP Ordinance 2284, an ordinance to declare surplus of a 2012 Ford Expedition Asset 23544, and a 2012 Chevrolet Silverado Asset 21550, and authorize the donation of said surplus assets to the town of Kentwood.
I'd like to make the motion.
Second.
A motion by Mr. Forrest, second by Mr. Ingraffia. Roll call, please.
Mr. Bruno?
Yes.
Mr. Richtel?
Yes.
Mr. Mayhew?
Yes.
Mr. Wells?
Yes.
Mr. VL?
Yes.
Ms. Hyde?
Yes.
Ms. Coates?
Yes.
Mr. Forrest?
Yes.
Mr. Ingraffia?
Yes.
Mr. Joseph?
Yes.
Adoption of TP Ordinance 2285, an ordinance to declare surplus of a 2017 Dodge 1500 Asset Number 24180, a 2015 Dodge 1500 Asset 21301, and a 2015 Dodge 1500 Asset 21525, and authorize the donation of said surplus assets to the town of Amite City Police.
So moved.
Second.
Have a motion by Mr. Joseph, second by Mr. Forrest. Roll call, please.
Mr. Richtel?
Yes.
Mr. Mayhew?
Yes.
Mr. Wells?
Yes.
Mr. Vial?
Yes.
Ms. Hyde?
Yes.
Ms. Coates?
Yes.
Mr. Forrest?
Yes.
Mr. Ngrafia?
Yes.
Mr. Joseph?
Yes.
Mr. Bruno?
Yes.
All right. Introduction of TP Ordinance 2276, an ordinance to redistrict the parish council districts of Tangipahoa Parish in accordance with the year 2020 Decennial Census Plan A. There will be public hearings on this item November the 30th, held at the Tangipahoa Consolidated Gravity Building in Tickfaw at 4:30. The next one will be December 7th at the same location at 4 o'clock, and December 12th at this building here at 5:30. And those are all on our website, correct?
Yes.
Mr. Zhu?
So moved.
And the map will be on the
And the map will also be loaded after tonight. Okay, I have a motion by Mr. Joseph.
Second.
Second by Mr. Ngrafia. Roll call, please.
Mr. Mayhew?
Yes.
Mr. Wells?
Yes.
Mr. Vial?
Yes.
Ms. Hyde?
Yes.
Ms. Coates?
Yes.
Mr. Forrest?
Yes.
Mr. Ngrafia?
Yes.
Mr. Joseph?
Yes.
Mr. Bruno?
Yes.
Mr. Richtel?
Yes.
All right. The next item is introduction of TP Ordinance 2282, an ordinance to authorize the parish president or his authorized designee to execute any and all documents in regard to the purchase of a land acquisition. This was actually
postponed.
Asked to be postponed tonight.
Yes, so. Please.
Second.
I have a motion by Mr. Bruno, second by Mr. Forrest, that we postpone this item.
Mr. Mayhew?
Yes.
Mr. Wells?
Yes.
Mr. Vial?
Yes.
Ms. Hyde?
Yes.
Ms. Coates?
Yes.
Mr. Forrest?
Yes.
Mr. Ngrafia?
Yes.
Mr. Joseph?
Yes.
Mr. Bruno?
Yes.
Mr. Richtel?
Yes.
Introduction of TP Ordinance 2286, an ordinance amending Section 2-05 of the Home Rule Charter, compensation of council members. This public hearing will be December 12th.
So moved. And second.
I have a motion by Mr. Bruno, second by Mr. Joseph.
I think we ought to explain how this process works.
Well, the last time that the council had an increase was in 2005. That went into effect January of 2008. So it's been 15 years that the council has not had an increase. So.
And this also means that this will not take effect.
That's the point I'm making here.
Your mic's not on.
Hey, put your mic's not on, Bruno.
Put your mic on. Your mic's not on. Right. This isn't for this council. It will be for the new council that will be elected next year.
This council will not receive it. It will be for the new council that is elected in November of 2023, and it will go into effect in January of 2024.
Correct.
So no one sitting on this board, unless they're reelected, will have the opportunity to share in this increase.
Yeah, and I think that's a fair process. I really do. Okay.
And it's a $400 increase. We have a motion by Mr. Bruno, second by Mr. Joseph.
Mr. Wells?
Yes.
Mr. Vial?
Yes.
Ms. Hyde?
Yes.
Ms. Coates?
Yes.
Mr. Forrest?
Yes.
Mr. Ngrafia?
Yes.
Mr. Joseph?
Yes.
Mr. Bruno?
Yes.
Mr. Richtel?
Yes.
Mr. Mayhew?
Yes.
Introduction of TP Ordinance 2287, an ordinance amending TP Ordinance number 2170, adoption of the operating and capital outlay budgets of the Tangipahoa Parish Council, President Government for fiscal year 2022.
I so move, Madam Chairman.
A second.
I have a motion by Mr. Wells, second by Mr. Joseph. Roll call, please.
Mr. Vial?
Yes.
Ms. Hyde?
Yes.
Ms. Coates?
Yes.
Mr. Forrest?
Yes.
Mr. Ngrafia?
Yes.
Mr. Joseph?
Yes.
Mr. Bruno?
Yes.
Mr. Richtel?
Yes.
Mr. Mayhew?
Yes.
Mr. Wells?
Yes.
Introduction of TP Ordinance 2288, an ordinance amending and enacting Chapter 36, Planning and Development, Article 5, Standards for Development of Property, Section 36-112, Special Classification Property Development Standards, A, Mobile/Manufactured Home Placement Standards for Placement on a Single Lot. Item 10, Permit expires within 180 days. This is being recommended by the Development Regulations Committee, and we're just basically putting an expiration date on that permit.
So move.
Second.
Have a motion by Mr. VL, second by Ms. Coates. Roll call, please.
Ms. Hyde?
Yes.
Ms. Coates?
Yes.
Mr. Forrest?
Yes.
Mr. Graffia?
Yes.
Mr. Joseph?
Yes.
Mr. Bruno?
Yes.
Mr. Richtel?
Yes.
Mr. Mayhew?
Yes.
Mr. Wells?
Yes.
Mr. VL?
Yes.
Introduction of TP Ordinance 2289, an ordinance amending and enacting Chapter 36, Planning and Development, Article 4, Standards for Subdivision of Property, Section 36-91, Major Subdivision Standards, A, General Design Standards, Item 2, Street Standards, I, Right-of-Way, and Q, Construction Entrances. This is actually a recommendation from our parish engineer. All streets, roads, right-of-way, 60 feet, we're just removing some language there, and then we're making a change on the temporary construction entrances to subdivisions.
Also move.
Second.
We have a motion by Mr. VL, second by Mr. Mayhew. Roll call, please.
Ms. Coates?
Yes.
Mr. Forrest?
Yes.
Mr. Graffia?
Yes.
Mr. Joseph?
Yes.
Mr. Bruno?
Yes.
Mr. Richtel?
Yes.
Mr. Mayhew?
Yes.
Mr. Wells?
Yes.
Mr. VL?
Yes.
Ms. Hyde?
Yes.
Mr. Chairman?
Yes.
When is the next committee meeting?
On the 12th, December 12th. Did you have something you need to get with me if you need to
Tracy, and we may have some things that may have to come up that may not be able to wait. We'll know better as soon as the meeting takes place.
Okay.
But I'd like to ask that you keep an open in case we have to, because we may need to take it and be able to introduce it and get it taking care of the first meeting in January if possible.
Okay. There was nothing pressing, so we just didn't we didn't schedule.
And we can put it off depending on what happens.
Okay. Yeah, just let me know. We'll call one if we need to. All right. Introduction of TP Ordinance 2290, an ordinance amending and enacting Chapter 42, Streets, Roads, Sidewalks, and Drainage, Article 1, in general, Section 42-21, Road Specifications, B, Subbase, 4, Clearing and Grubbing. This is also a change being recommended by our parish engineer.
Yeah, it gives a lot more specifics about the work that is affected or it needs to be done, so I'm so move.
And I'll second.
A motion by Mr. VL, second by Ms. Coates. Roll call, please.
Mr. Forrest?
Yes.
Mr. Graffia?
Yes.
Mr. Joseph?
Yes.
Mr. Bruno?
Yes.
Mr. Richtel?
Yes.
Mr. Mayhew?
Yes.
Mr. Wells?
Yes.
Mr. VL?
Yes.
Ms. Hyde?
Yes.
Ms. Coates?
Yes.
Okay. Introduction of TP Ordinance 2291, an ordinance amending and enacting Chapter 46, Taxation, Article 3, Occupancy Tax, Division 1, General, Marketplace Facilitators. This was actually drafted by our attorney, Mr. Cassio, and it's pertaining to Airbnb properties paying occupancy tax to the parish.
To move.
Second.
Have a motion by Mr. VL, second by Mr. Joseph. Roll call, please.
Mr. Graffia?
Yes.
Mr. Joseph?
Yes.
Mr. Bruno?
He stepped out.
Mr. Richtel?
Yes.
Mr. Mayhew?
Yes.
Mr. Wells?
Yes.
Mr. VL?
Yes.
Ms. Hyde?
Yes.
Ms. Coates?
Yes.
Mr. Forrest?
Yes.
All right. I have two board appointments. The first is Tangipahoa Parish Fire Protection District Number 1. We have a reappointment of Mary Bennett. This is the second term, which will expire in December of 2024, and a new appointment of Reggie Foster. This is the first term, which will expire in December 2024. And these are both in Mr. Joseph's district.
Yeah, those are mine. But please allow me to say.
Yes, sir.
I'm reappointing Moses Gonzalo also. I didn't hear that name.
I didn't have that. No. Well, that's for the hospital board.
Okay, all right. So move.
Okay.
Second.
Have a motion by Mr. Joseph, second by Mr. Graffia. Roll call, please.
Mr. Richtel?
Yes.
Mr. Mayhew?
Yes.
Mr. Wells?
Yes.
Mr. VL?
Yes.
Ms. Hyde?
Yes.
Ms. Coates? Mr. Forrest?
Yes.
Mr. Ingraffia?
Yes.
Mr. Joseph?
Yes.
Mr. Bruno?
Yes.
Now I have the Hospital District 2, which is the Hood Hospital Board.
Yes, Moses Cazardo. So moved.
All right.
Second.
Motion by Mr. Joseph, second by Mr. Forrest. Roll call, please.
Mr. Mayhew?
Yes.
Mr. Wells?
Yes.
Mr. Beal?
Yes.
Ms. Hyde?
Yes.
Ms. Coates?
Yes.
Mr. Forrest?
Yes.
Mr. Ingraffia?
Yes.
Mr. Joseph?
Yes.
Mr. Bruno?
Yes.
Mr. Richtel?
Yes.
Mr. Forrest?
Yes.
Mr. Ingraffia?
Yes.
Mr. Joseph?
Yes.
Mr. Bruno?
Yes.
Mr. Richtel?
Yes.
Mr. Forrest?
Yes.
Mr. Ingraffia?
Yes.
Mr. Joseph?
Yes.
Mr. Bruno?
Yes.
Mr. Richtel?
Yes.
Mr. Forrest?
Yes.
Mr. Ingraffia?
Yes.
Mr. Joseph?
Yes.
Mr. Forrest?
Yes.
Mr. Ingraffia?
Yes.
Mr. Joseph?
Yes.
Mr. Bruno?
Yes.
Mr. Richtel?
Yes.
Mr. Forrest?
Yes.
Mr. Ingraffia?
Yes.
Mr. Joseph?
Yes.
Mr. Bruno?
Yes.
Mr. Richtel?
Yes.
Mr. Forrest?
Yes.
Mr. Ingraffia?
Yes.
Mr. Joseph?
Yes.
Mr. Bruno?
Yes.
Mr. Richtel?
Yes.
Mr. Forrest?
Yes.
Mr. Ingraffia?
Yes.
Mr. Joseph?
Yes.
Mr. Bruno?
Yes.
Mr. Richtel?
Yes.
Mr. Forrest?
Yes.
Mr. Ingraffia?
Yes.
Mr. Joseph?
Yes.
Mr. Bruno?
Yes.
Mr. Richtel?
Yes.
Mr. Forrest?
Yes.
Mr. Ingraffia?
Yes.
Mr. Joseph?
Yes.
Mr. Bruno?
Yes.
Mr. Richtel?
Yes.
Mr. Forrest?
Yes.
Mr. Ingraffia?
Yes.
Mr. Joseph?
Yes.
Mr. Bruno?
Yes.
Mr. Richtel?
Yes.
Mr. Forrest?
Yes.
Mr. Ingraffia?
Yes.
Mr. Joseph?
Yes.
Mr. Bruno?
Yes.
Mr. Richtel?
Yes.
Mr. Forrest?
Yes.
Mr. Ingraffia?
Yes.
Mr. Joseph?
Yes.
Mr. Bruno?
Yes.
Mr. Richtel?
Yes.